Hello guys, I hope you all are doing good. I'm Vishali Kikan and we are discussing the antennas and the wave propagation. Today in this video, we are going to talk about a very important type of antenna, that is the sleeve antenna. Sleeve antenna is also known as the dipole sleeve antenna, right? It is called as a coaxial sleeve antenna as well. Now, why it is called as a dipole sleeve antenna or the coaxial sleeve antenna? We are going to understand this with the structure of the sleeve antenna, right? So the sleeve antenna is having the two elements like we have in the dipole antenna. So it is having two elements, same like the dipole antenna. In the dipole antenna, we have the total length to be equal to lambda by 2. So we have lambda by 4 length of two elements, right? So here you can see we have the conductive wire. Conductive wire is having the length lambda upon 4, and then we have this sleeve. Sleeve is the metallic jacket, and inside the sleeve we have the coaxial cable. Now the coaxial cable is having the structure. So this is the coaxial cable. So the coaxial cable is having the metallic. So the coaxial cable is having the metallic outer jacket, and inside that we have a metallic conductor. So this is how our coaxial cable will be looking like. I hope you all must have seen a coaxial cable, right? So now it is wrapped. So this is the metallic wire which is wrapped, and inside here we have the copper or any kind of conductive material, right? So here we have the coaxial cable. I hope now you understood its structure. So here this metallic jacket is folded over here, and now here it is connected to the conductive wire with the help of this center conductor. So here we will be having the center conductor. After that we have the dielectric insulator, and this is how we have connected the coaxial cable with the conductive wire. Now coaxial cable is wrapped inside the sleeve, which is the metallic sleeve that we have. Now here also we have this coaxial cable. Outside the metallic sleeve also we have the coaxial cable. So the length of the sleeve is 1 by 4 lambda, or lambda by 4, or I can say it to be quarter wavelength. So I hope you understood the diagram or the structure of the sleeve antenna. We have the conductive wire, we have the sleeve. Inside the sleeve we have this coaxial cable. The coaxial cable is having the metallic outer coating. So this metallic outer coating is connected to the dielectric insulator, and now it is welded to the conductive wire. So conductive wire and the sleeve are both lambda by 4 length long, and it is also known as the coaxial sleeve antenna because of this reason, because here we have the coaxial wire inside it. I hope you understood this. So now it is also called the balanced antenna. Why it is called the balanced antenna? The balanced antenna does not require the balloon. So balloon is required whenever I have unbalanced structure. Now whenever it is fed by the coaxial cable, we have unbalanced feed lines, and the balloon is needed. But here in this case we have the sleeve as well. So here coaxial cable is connected to the conductive wire, and balloon was needed because there was some mismatch and unbalanced feed line was there. But the sleeve, this metallic sleeve, is acting as a balloon, and it is going to prevent the unwanted radiations or unwanted losses that are going outside, right? So the sleeve will be acting like a balloon. It counters the effect of the current that is returning back along the outer braid of the coaxial cable. So current will not go back along the outer braid or the outer metallic structure of the coaxial cable, and the current has to move in the forward direction only due to the presence of the sleeve. Now the radiation pattern will be same like the dipole antenna. It is in the donut shape. I hope you remember. In the dipole antenna, we discussed about the omnidirectional radiation pattern which look like a donut. I hope all of you must have seen the donut. So it is directional in one direction and omnidirection, or I can say non-direction. If I see from the upward direction, I can see it as a circular, non-directional type of antenna. But if I see it from here, you can see we have a peak over here and a peak over here. So it is directional from one direction and non-direction from one direction. It is having a gain which is around 2.15 dB. The maximum gain can go up to 2.75 dB, right? And the gain will not go beyond that, right? The VSWR will be less than equal to 2.0 only, and it is having the impedance which is 50 ohm. So input impedance is less, VSWR is a good parameter that we have over here, and the side lobe level is minus 28 dB, right? Which is also a kind of not required parameter that we have. The polarization is both horizontal and the vertical, and the housing material in which this full structure is wrapped is ABS. It is used as a radio wave antennas. Okay, in the radios you must have seen a structure over the radio which was like this. So this type of antennas are present over the radios. If you have seen the previously used radios, it is used as both the transmitter and the receiver because it can be used in a wide range of frequencies. If I work it as a transmitter, or if I use it as a receiver also, it can be operated over a wide range of frequencies. So it is sturdier, it cannot be easily degraded. So now the application, as I told you, it is used in the radio, so it can be used in the radio base stations as well, and it can be used for in the maritime ships, from ship to ship and ship to shore radio antennas. I hope you understood the sleeve antennas really well. If you have any doubt regarding the structure or the any characteristics of the sleeve antenna, I hope you will be putting it in the comment, and I will be trying to resolve your doubt as soon as possible. I hope you like this session. If you like it, please push the like button, subscribe to the channel, share it with your friends, and give me your feedback. Thank you so much.